understand evolution and do we understand it well enough to be able to predict it? First, we'll discuss how evolution caused all these different life forms. These life forms are different in the way they look and they behave. It's just passed on from one generation to the next. Now, these differences weren't always there. They came into existence through the process of evolution. Evolution is a combination of two processes. One causing random changes, such as mutations in the DNA, and the other one is selection, which makes the individuals that are best fit for the current environment passing on their DNA to the next generation. Environment can consist of different factors, such as, for example, temperature, toxicity, and humidity. Some variation might be very good in one environment, but when the environment changes, this variation might not be so good anymore, and other variation will be good. When these changes add up over long periods of time, these can cause these different life forms to evolve over millions of years. Now we can of course study species in isolation, but in nature all these species interact, such as for example in a predator-prey system. So what usually happens in a system where a predator eats a prey is that the prey population increases in numbers. Then when there's a lot of food, the predator population starts to increase. But now the prey gets eaten and the prey population decreases. Because there's no food, the predator population decreases. And this process continues. In 2003, a group of scientists in the United States studied such a predator-prey system in the lab. And they monitored the population densities. But they didn't see exactly the dynamics they expected. And after careful study, they found out it was evolution that was acting on these timescales and changing the dynamics of predator-prey interactions. Now, when I read about this study, it made me realize evolution is not only important on these millions of years timescales, but it happens fast and it's happening now. So I've argued that we understand evolution, but do we understand it well enough to predict it? So imagine, if we keep the conditions constant and we evolve a species under these constant conditions several times, will evolution cause the same changes every time? Therefore, I study a predator-prey system in the lab of a predator roundworm and a bacterial prey. And the predator makes the prey evolve to avoid being eaten. In this case, for example, it could evolve a thicker cell wall. This in turn gives selection to the predator to be able to still eat this prey. And this again will select for changes in the prey. We know when there is very strong selection, there are only a few changes of large effect that can be passed on to the next generation, making evolution more repeatable. On the other hand, if the prey evolves in a slightly different manner, this might give slightly different selection pressure on the predator, and it might also evolve in a slightly different manner. If these differences add up over longer timescales, evolution might become less repeatable. Now, in nature, when species live together, they also evolve together. But in the lab, we can freeze our initial populations and revive them again, putting a stop to evolution. We can evolve one species while replenishing the other one from the freezer. Also, we can always go back to the initial species and evolve them again under the same conditions. So when we evolve them several times in the lab, we can also see if these changes are the same every time. Now, it's feasible to study this system in the lab, but there's still a faster way to do it. Therefore, we also made a computational model. So we know a lot about these species. We know their DNA and how they act under different conditions. And we can put this information in our model and study under which conditions evolution is most repeatable. Then we can take this knowledge back to determine our conditions in the lab. So we do not know if evolution is predictable or if it's even repeatable under the same conditions. But we do know it happens much faster than we once thought. By studying these fast evolutionary cycles, we can determine if evolution is random or predictable, and how it depends on external conditions and species interactions.